करुणाकर सूरीन्द्र गुरुवर्य पदाम्बुजाम नवनीत नटोत्तम साम गुरुपंक्ति श्रीयन्नु महा। तिरुप्पावै अ ट्रेजर हाउस ऑफ थ्री स्पासुरम 18। थ्री नेम्स ऑफ नप्पिन्नै देवी हैव बीन कन्वेड थ्रू दिस स्पासुरम। नप्पिन्नै वॉज द कॉन्सर्ट ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा हु हैज बीन संग बाय आंडाल इन हर पासुरम्स। नप्पिन्नै is requested by Andal and her friends to come and guide them in their Margari Vrata. As Andal calls out to Nappinnai, she uses three different names in Pasuram 18. First, she calls out to Nappinnai as Nanda Gopalan Marumagale. Nappinnai is called out as the daughter-in-law of Nanda Gopa. Secondly, Gandham Kamalum Kudali, says Andal. Nappinnai is the one who has fragrant hair. And thirdly, Pandar Virali. Nappinnai is seen to be the one who is holding a ball by her hand. Why is Andal using such kind of exclamations or names to call out to Nappinnai? The answer is, through these names or through these Sambodhanams, Andal wants to convey the greatness of Nappinnai and to show us how exemplary was Nappinnai in showing us Stri Dharma. Nappinnai is addressed as the daughter-in-law of Nanda Gopa at first. This conveys that Nappinnai was a great woman, a Uttama Stri, who added glory to the house where she got wedded to. Everybody in Gokulam would be so proud of Nappinnai for being the daughter-in-law of Nanda Gopa. Such was her bond with each and every person in her in-law's place. Secondly, Nappinnai is addressed as Gandham Kamalum Kudali, the one having fragrant hair. Through this, Andal wants to convey that Nappinnai was Sadrisha or suitable in all ways to her consort Krishna. It seems the fragrant hair of Nappinnai would attract all her friends to her side and let them be by her side always. Similarly, Lord Krishna is called as Shabdam Kavarum Kudalan, meaning the one who attracts everybody through the melodious notes of his flute. So both Nappinnai and Krishna had the art of attracting devotees to them by showing their greatness and simplicity. Thirdly, Nappinnai is called out as Pandar Virali, the one holding the ball in hand. Why is this so? It is said that Nappinnai and Krishna were playing a game with each other by passing the ball, and finally it was decided that the one who has the ball in hand at the end of the game would be declared the winner. So here Nappinnai was having the ball in her hand, declaring to the world that she was the winner of the game. Well, this ball denotes the samsara or the world with all the mortals inside. And Nappinnai had won over this world with the mortals and had the right to do anything with them. What would Nappinnai do with these mortals? She would be kind to them and grant them mercy and asylum. Thus, the ball in Nappinnai's hand, making her Pandar Virali, shows her affection or vatsalyam towards all living beings, which is the best characteristic of a woman. Thus, these three names of Nappinnai show the three best qualities of a woman, of how she should be a value addition to the family where she gets wedded to, of how she should be suitable and complementary to her husband at all times, and how she must be ever affectionate to everybody. Hailing Nappinnai thrice, let us all see in tomorrow's Pasuram the secret of another three. Andal Thiruvadigale Sharanam.